There, my lovelies, and welcome back to another episode of Creative Gaming, The Forest. So, as you can see, it's nighttime here in my little cabin, and I will happily show you the outside of the camp and what's changed once it turns to daylight. So, let me just pop my cozy fire on, as I have a couple of things to talk about before we get started. Let's just sit down here. So, first off, I'd like to say to anybody who hasn't seen this series, please feel free to watch episodes 1 and 2, as a lot of the building and construction has already partly been done. So if you want to see how it all started, please feel free to click on the link below to watch episode 1. But for those of you who have seen both episodes 1 and 2, this is carrying on from the last episode, where we were doing a small tour of new parts of the build, such as the outdoor swimming pool and the lookout posts. Now, these episodes are going to be a little bit different from now on, as unfortunately I cannot use the cheat mod that I was using for the original episodes. And basically what happened was the game has had a pretty decent sized update, which means that my cheat mod no longer works with this current version. So all the builds that I will be doing from now on are going to have to be done pretty much by hand, the old fashioned way. So I will be doing a lot of gathering of resources, both on and off camera, and once I pop outside I will show you what I've been up to. But first, oh, it's actually daylight out there now, so first I'm going to grab this little log here and here we go. So this is going to be my four poster double bed, and you may remember from the last episode I said I was going to try my best to build one, and I did build two that weren't very successful. So this is the third attempt, and believe me, it's looking a lot better than the last ones. So let's just finish this off, and there we have the base of my bed. So now I need to pop the actual bed on top. So there we go. Oh, I think it's a bit wonky. Let's try that again. So, as I said, this does mean that I will have to gather most of my resources myself, which means these two pieces of cloth that I'm missing I'll have to gather. But I do have the sticks to hand, so let's go and grab those. This also means that, as you might be able to see down in the bottom corner, my character is both hungry and thirsty. Now, the mod that I was using basically stopped this from happening. It was on a sort of god mode, if you will, which means that I could focus on building rather than having to look after my character's needs like in my other save files. So I do apologize, but occasionally I will have to feed this little guy and make sure he's okay. Otherwise, this game will end very abruptly. So let's just pop our sticks on. I'm gonna have to finish that in the next episode, I think. What I will do is I will go and give you a tour of the house so far. So for those of you who have seen the previous episodes, again, this is the bedroom. Through here is my armory. It's a little bit bare at the moment, but I will be putting more storage and items in there. Have our armor rack, which again is a little bit bare. I will be making some armor to put on this guy, and some storage baskets. And out this window, you guys may remember, ooh, that was good timing. You may remember from episode 2, I was building an outdoor swimming pool. So that is that little beauty there, complete with underwater lighting, which is really cool if you want to go for a midnight swim. Let's just pop around the corner here. And again, this is the living room with my fireplace, seating, and the small dining table. Then we have the kitchen with a little sink. Lots of storage for my many, many herbal remedies that I make. Some food and my makeshift cooker. Let's light this baby up. There we go. It also provides warmth for when my character is cold and wet. So, lots of lighting. Guys know how much I like my skull lights, so as every heavy metaler should, put some skull lights in your house. Okay, let's just get rid of that. Don't need you for the moment. I have my little water collector here, and it's still raining, so that'll fill up nicely. I have my two boxes on the front of my house for plants, but I don't have any seeds just yet to put in there. Hi, Mr. Bunny. What are you doing? Okay. The biggest change to the base is this huge wall that goes around the entire camp. It took so long to build this. I started building it when I had the cheat mod, so I had half of it auto-built very quickly, but the other half I had to build manually, and overall I think I've spent about 8 hours building this week, not just the fence but the other parts of the fort, house, whatever you want to call it. So let's just back up a second so you can see it in all its grandeur. So we have the main section of the house here, and this bit on the outside is what I've been working on. So here are my new stone holders. Are bigger versions of the originals, and this came in with the new patch update, so I can have even more storage, which is good. So for future builds, I'll be able to stock up before filming, and it'll be a lot easier to build with. So round through to the garden area, and I've built some more. Oh, that was useful. Let's plant some more. out some more flower beds and areas for food. I don't have many seeds at the moment, so again, once I have some more seeds, I'll be able to plant more. Believe it or not, this whole building here took over 300 stones to put together, and it took me absolutely hours to build. It was definitely a labour of love. So, down here we have a little pathway, and underneath, as you can see, it's still part of the lake. So there is water down here, and a little walkway, and overhead I built this sort of little overhead way of it. I may turn this into like a walkway, so like a sheltered walkway. I'm not sure yet how it's all going to join up, but this comes back here to the back area of the house. So you have the treehouse up there and all the walkways, which I'm going to show you as well. Here's my storage area, and every single one of these was absolutely full of logs earlier for me to build the base and the roof. Hi, Mr. Birdie. Look, you're on YouTube. Shy. So let's hop on up. Oops, Daisy. Down there is where the outdoor pool is. This is the top of the extension to the house. And out there is the beach. And I have a nice little path going directly from my base to the beach, which is really cool. A little walkway. Over there is the treehouse, and over here is where I have my gazebo, complete with chair, and I love where I've placed it because there's some nice trees, and as you can see, it's a really nice spot just to sort of sit and watch the world go by. Super happy with how this is turning out, this build, but obviously I want to expand and add more, so let me know what you guys think and what else I should build here. This is my treehouse with just a little bed, and this is how I save my game, so I don't really want to get rid of this just yet. And you can get a good overview of the house. Okay, so up there is a little bit of roof that I actually cannot finish because when I had the cheat mod installed, you could fly in it, which was really useful for building things in high places, such as custom roofs and the stone chimney that you might be able to see in the corner here. Yep, just where my axe is pointing. But unfortunately, I now can't get up there without building some sort of a ladder, possibly, so let's just climb down. Okay. And back to the garden. So I don't know whether I'll extend this one out, maybe knock one of the walls down and build around, possibly. I do have a lot of space to work with, so anything's possible. I really love building on water, but it does have its challenges. Obviously, you have to build platforms before you can build anything on top of it. So, let's go in the back entrance this way. Here we are. I need to maybe make a double roof, I think, because when it rains, water comes through the gap. So I have these big windows to look out of, which is really nice. Let's see, do I have enough items to build some lights? I don't have any skulls at the moment, so I have an idea. I'm going to place some lights, and then we're going to go on a bit of an adventure to rustle up some materials. Pop one there. And another one by the door, I think. Okay. So, guys, we're gonna go on an adventure outside of the camp. Scary. Grab some sap. I didn't know when I started building the space that there is actually a bad guy's encampment right next to it. So it's a good thing I have it on passive mode, otherwise we'd be in big trouble. There we go. All of the bits I need. So this is where the bad guys live. But fortunately for us, there are no bad guys here. And the baddies happen to have the best loot. Mr. Rabbit! You do look very confused. Oh, come on, little guy. Oh, there we go, be free. I think I saved him. Let's see, what else can I grab? Anyone who's just joined, this may look a little confusing as to why I'm beating up suitcases, and that's because these are part of the plane crash that you are in as the main character. There is actually a lot of story behind this game, and I don't want to give you any spoilers, so all I can say for now is that you are a survivor of a plane crash, and you've landed on this very odd island with some eccentric natives, let's put it that way. Hi, birdies. Lizzie, don't run away, Lizzie. Our little guy is very hungry, so let's make sure we feed him. And always make sure you're eating the edible ones and not the poisonous berries. So I don't know how true this is, but I did read on a forum somewhere that the blue berries that I've just eaten, you can use to paint with. My axe, you'll notice, is blue, and that's because I've painted it, but somewhere I read that you can actually like paint your base with the berries, like as a dye, so I don't know how true that is, but if you guys know, that's drawn, let me know. Okay, now we have our skulls and our sticks. There's one. Oh no, I'm missing a stick. Good thing I have plenty on my stick holder. Any ideas on what we should put in here? Maybe some furniture of some sort? Maybe a nice rug? I don't think I want a trap. We have food and water. We don't have an explosive holder. That's new. Ooh, target for target practice. That would be cool outdoors, I think. And that requires paint as well, so that might be something to make in the future. Going to do now is make a little walkway. So this is going to require a lot of stones. Okay, so I'm gonna do that and that. Build the blueprints for the moment so I can get an idea of where to put things. That's good. I want to leave this side a bit more open so I can just pop in and grab my materials. Yeah, that's going to look good. And then join them up there, I think. Grab some rocks. Look how spooky my place looks at night. Good thing about building with rocks is they respawn really quickly around here, which is why I can collect so many in such a short time, because they're pretty much everywhere. See what I mean? And because I made my rock bag, which increases my rock carrying capacity, I can carry about 10 to 20 rocks instead of 5, which again makes it a lot quicker to build with. Okay, let's just add you on top. So I'm going to keep adding upwards until this is more like an enclosed walkway. But I'm gonna leave this episode here for now and go and collect some more materials to build with. So there's not really much more I can build as such, in terms of like furniture and items inside, but let me know what you guys would like to see. Whether you want me to build a second, like building, maybe like a second house, or maybe I could build something on the beach. We could build a houseboat or even just a boat. That would be kind of cool. And we could go sailing around the island. Yeah, just a few sort of ideas. Oh, hi, Mr. Bodhi. It's back again. So, before I go, I just want to say thank you guys so much for watching this series. I've had a lot of positive comments about it, and I'm so glad that you're all enjoying it as much as I am playing. I haven't forgotten about my ASMR artsy videos. They are basically just on hold for a few days while I sort out some technical issues with my laptop. But I do have a very special roleplay video coming up at the end of the week, so stay tuned for that. I can't wait to show you guys, but I won't spoil the surprise. So, for now, thank you guys so much for watching, and as always, I will see you in the next video. Bye guys.